This is the ugliest rear light in history. And that's why we're today going to install a smaller one. Here. So that's today's mission. Install a smaller rear light. So we're going to start by removing this. And then we have two screws here. Once those are out, you can lift the lens off. This is a bit broken. It doesn't matter, it doesn't want to change. Like that. And then this comes off like so. So then we have to remember which cable goes to what. We have the black one, that's the negative. The blue one is for the brake light. And the black and yellow one is for the rear light. So now the wiring is off. Then we have to loosen these two screws, and that you have to do from the inside of the fender. So if you take this and take it up here, you can get your hand up. That's one out. Take number two. Number two. And then this comes off. This new rear light comes with a gasket, so you can start by fitting this gasket. Pull the wires through this hole. So remove this rubber and pull the wires through here. So we can start with doing that. So that's the old one removed. Like that. And now we have to try to get the gasket straight. And you have, as you can see here, you have a hole here in the gasket that fits over this edge. You have that on both, no, only on the downside. So we make this fit over there. Then it should be straight. And this is the holder for the light bulb. We're going to have to rebuild this, but first off we're going to drill a new hole here to fit this in the fender. So I made a mark here, and now I will drill a hole, and then I will make new threads in the hole. So there we go, a hole. Now we make some threads in there. Since this is an old type of rear light, it only comes with a socket for one bulb, and that's because it has no brake light. So I have to rebuild this a bit to get a rear light and a brake light into this. I won't have any light for the sign, but that doesn't matter. So I have to take this off and then mount this instead. That's made for two bulbs. So I'm going to try to do that. So I started by removing this from here. And then I have to take this away. And also I drilled a hole here. So now remove this like that. So that's easily done just by bending it. So now I can fit this into that hole. Fit this there and then this over that hole, and I will put it with a screw in there. this light that I'm putting in is made for getting the negative or the ground through the chassis. But I have this cable here, so I'm going to use that. So I have to make that fit here also on this, so I can get the negative here. So now I'm going to cut this cable shoe from the negative cable and put this on. And then I can put that here and then put the screw over. So I put a screw here with the negative wire here, and we said that the blue one is for the brake light and the yellow and black is for the rear light. So I will cut these cable shoes off and I'll put the brake light on the top and the rear light in the bottom. Now everything is fitted. I put a 10 watt bulb for the brake light and a 5 watt bulb for the rear light. So now we can fit the lens. Make sure not to over tighten the screws, because then you will damage the lens. Now I'm finished and I think it looks great. It's much better than the old big one. And of course, when it's time for the MOTs, it won't be legal, but then you just switch back to the old light. So I think this looks very good.